And good morning, everyone, and welcome to Real Estate and Other Stuff, and it's gotten to be a lot of other stuff, on KHTS, 1220 AM and 98.1 FM, and on Facebook Live. Hi, everybody.
Feel free to look. The nose is healed.
Yes, her nose is healed. Whose nose is healed? That's right. It's Teddy Williams-Moniz.
Yeah.
Yes, your friend in the attorney business.
If there is such a thing, I'm your gal.
I was thinking about this. It's so weird about the stuff that I think about sometimes. What would you rather be called, an attorney or a lawyer?
Doesn't matter.
What's the difference?
Same. Doesn't matter.
Oh, they're the same?
Yeah, I don't care.
I always wondered what the difference was. There's no difference. There's lawyers and
attorneys. I mean, I'm sure, I don't know. But I don't know off the top of my head.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, you know, like a lawyer and a barrister, right? Those are two different countries.
Oh, yes. So. Yes. A barrister would be England, I believe. Yes.
It would indeed.
Well, you know what?
So,
hi, Patrick.
Hi.
How are you?
Doing good. How are you?
Terrific. How's Emily?
She's fine.
You know, one of these days I'm going to ask, I'm going to feel really bad because you're going to go, we broke up or something. I mean, I don't want that to happen, but I mean, I will feel really bad if
Taylor.
It does happen. So I should ask you before
you
we get on the air.
No.
Taylor, help.
What?
Patty, I will never allow that to happen. Shush. Absolutely not. Shush.
Well, what kind of a show would we have if I shushed?
I know. No. Just as to that.
Here's 3 days before Valentine's Day. You give me that.
No.
Gosh,
I didn't wish it.
You know what else is awful? I ask you how Judy is all the time. Poor Greg Agug, you never ask on the air how he's doing.
You know why? Because he's got something that's just above him, and that's that cute little Cameron.
The baby. I know that's true.
Little C just like steals everybody's thunder.
Cute. I've become that annoying woman. Feels like, how's the baby? I'm like, I took a video. You have to look at it. It's a minute long.
You know?
And like halfway through the video, I'm like, I'm disgusted with myself. I like grab the phone back. I'm like, stop watching. I'm sorry. That's ridiculous. He's cute. We're fine. Thanks for asking.
You know what's funny is when you walked in and you sat down and I said, how's Cameron? And I swear to God, you had this like this glow come to your face. And I thought, that's adorable.
And then you ask about work and I'm like,
right? No, that was adorable.
Well,
and I wasn't saying anything. My point was that I should check before.
Agreed.
Before we go on air, how are things going? Because
I
would hate.
He'd probably let us know, you know, as his legal guardian.
No, probably not. No, because we come in here and he's crying all the time anyway. So we wouldn't know.
We'd
have no idea. Aww. No. Patty,
I promise he's not going to make fun of you for the whole show. I mean, we've got a whole lot.
We got business.
Okay. Yeah,
exactly.
So a couple things. All right. First thing is, tomorrow, bad day, good day, bad day. Okay. I'm just going to say for me. That's just the way it is. Tomorrow, bad day, good day, bad
day.
You ready? Tomorrow, Judy's birthday.
Great.
Bad day. Bad day.
Wait, why is that bad?
Why is that bad?
Because I always feel like such a loser on Judy's birthday.
I'm going to need much more information.
Clarity.
Yeah.
It's really pretty simple, okay?
Okay.
Judy, okay, when I get a paycheck, I know it sounds crazy. When I get a paycheck, I give it to Judy, right?
It does not sound crazy.
Okay, so.
Greg, take notes.
Also, because I do that. I also say, I really don't care if you want something, go buy it.
Right.
Whenever you want to go buy it. And she does, and it's great. And that's why we know all of the delivery people by name.
Yeah.
We give them Christmas presents.
So do we. That's so funny.
Yeah.
Our
and
Amazon
so,
guy.
So,
yeah.
And so anyway, but then it comes to her birthday. Now I have to buy her something. Christmas is easier because Christmas we all do wish lists, and she'll do a wish list, and she'll have 15 things on the wish list, and I buy all 15, and then I wrap them, and it's fun. Birthday.
How have you not utilized me? I mean, keep going, but I'm gonna shame you at the end of this.
I hate it. I'll go to the mall. I'll go over here. I'll ask my kids. I'll say, hey, what should I get? Can you actually order it for me? Blah, blah. And you know what? Even they go, I don't know what mom wants. I gotta go to you.
Tap in on a new resource.
Yeah,
I could help you.
I'm worried about you though, because you're
just
gonna give me
a budget.
Exactly right. Uh-huh. You're gonna give me so anyway. So it's a source of contention. And what I do a lot of times is she'll go, "Do you want to just wrap the stuff that I ordered this week?"
You're like, "Not really."
And I go, "Yeah, absolutely."
Oh,
because that way she can open something. Right?
But she already knows what it is. That's counterintuitive. Waste of paper.
She knows what it is when she gives everybody a wish list for Christmas.
See, this makes me sad.
See, I told you.
I'll help you.
I told you. I hate the day.
Okay, you don't hate the day. It's just
I hate my the
celebration
feeling that I get.
Oh,
it's awesome. Yeah, because the kids come over and it's all great.
Okay, well,
right?
There you go.
That's awesome.
Yes.
But I do feel like a loser.
Okay.
Because I know when she's opening most.
Next year, I got you.
It's not like I haven't given her presents, but I know exactly what I give her. She's going to go, oh, thank you. That's awesome. And then she'll probably
ask for the gift receipt.
Ask, exactly right.
So Mark Young, my partner, hopefully he's not listening or his wife isn't listening. Her birthday's coming up and got the hookup.
I should have. But I, like I said, I worry about you. You're going to go, here, get her this.
Greg's
or this.
Like, don't involve Taylor. Don't do it. It's expensive.
Dive.
Just give me a budget. Okay, but happy early birthday to Judy.
Yeah, thank
okay,
you.
So that's
and
the
then
good,
Super Bowl,
day.
That's a good day.
Well,
right.
It's Sunday, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Sunday.
Super Bowl Sunday, that's Sunday. Yeah. And then right. The day after that's Valentine's Day, and I go through the same thing. Right?
Oh,
yeah, think about it. So anyway, okay. So we got through that.
Patty, are you guys doing anything for Valentine's?
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cute. Don't ask anything else, that's all. He said yes. We'll leave it at that.
Yes.
That's exciting.
Yay. You don't want
Greg and I are going to dinner.
Oh.
He's never home for Valentine's Day. I was like, oh, you made dinner reservations for amateur day? He's like, mean? He's like, at least I'm home and I made an effort. I'm like, you're right. I'm a horrible wife. I'm excited.
Well, in a couple of weeks, we're going to expect some good news out of you then, right? He's going to be home. That's awesome. Let's start working on baby number two.
Yeah, until I have triplets and ask you to come over and watch them. Yeah, careful what you wish for, Joe.
Oh, whoops.
Woo.
No, I better be quiet.
That's what I'm saying. That's the theme
it's time
of
for me.
Today.
It's time for me to be
rain
quiet.
Fill in.
Okay, so I was looking.
What else we got?
I was looking at the signal today. I
yeah,
love the signal.
I do too.
Whenever I talk about the signal, it's a whopping 4 pages deep, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you
can get through it pretty quickly.
It's hard to pick up because it's just so heavy. So I'm surprised they don't blow away. You know, I'm
that's
serious.
The wind actually
that's
a very good point.
Yeah. So here's a fill in the blanks. See if either of you get it.
Oh no.
Okay.
All right, Patty, help me
so
out.
So first
here.
Thing is every time I talk about the signal, I always talk about the fact that we're a small town and you know what makes the actual headlines are dead skunk ties up traffic, right? But that's
right.
Like a big thing. Mm-hmm. Okay, so here's one that I thought it just jumped out at me. Quit, you're cheating. Okay, you ready for this?
I am.
Man arrested on suspicion of possessing drugs and stolen blank.
Do you know the answer to this, by the way? Okay.
Okay, I'm going to read it again. Man arrested on suspicion of possessing drugs and stolen blank. Now, you're not going to get it from that, probably. So I'm going to wait for a second, and then I'll give you one hint, then I'll give you two hints, and I don't think you're going to get it.
Okay.
But what do you think?
I was going to say an animal.
An animal?
Some kind of animal, like stolen animal.
Okay. What do you say?
I'm going to say sports equipment.
Okay. Ooh. Okay.
I think we're both wrong.
Yeah
close.
Ooh.
Now, I'm going to tell you right now. It's four letters.
Four,
okay? That's
four
your
letters.
First. That's your first.
Well, which one?
He goes
2, 3, 4. Bang. Wait, which one of us is close?
He counts on his fingers. Let's see, 1, 2, 3. Oh, that's that many.
Which one of us is?
I
close?
Really did.
I can't say. I can't say.
Hmm.
All right.
All right. Fair. Okay. Four letters.
All right. Four letters.
Goat.
Man arrested on suspicion of possessing drugs and stolen blank. Four letters.
Boat.
Boat.
Oh, a boat or
a
goat.
Oh, good for you. A boat or a goat.
We rhyme. Yeah, this is going to be a long game. All right. Next.
Okay. Last
clue.
Yeah,
okay.
Last clue. It starts with an M.
Mans.
And stolen mans?
I don't know.
Well, that would be kidnapping, I believe.
Yes, it would, but you can reword it.
Yep.
Mask?
And stolen mask?
That's pretty
close.
That's a good one.
You guys give up?
Yes.
Who wins? I'm going to tell you right now, Taylor, you won.
I knew it. I totally knew it.
Because you were the closest, but you didn't get it.
Okay.
The correct answer is meat. And you said some kind of animal.
All right,
right?
I'll take it. I'll take it.
So I guess this guy stole and he had meat.
he went to Costco. I need some filet with my drugs.
Something like that. Yeah, he stole alcohol, which I think he probably should
that's
have said.
That's what I was
alcohol,
thinking, like booze.
Right.
Yeah.
And,
but then that's
and,
too
and,
obvious.
And then, but meat. So you didn't get that right.
Dude,
but,
meat's expensive. Saying
that is
like,
absolutely.
So we had people over the other night. I'm buying like ribeyes and filet, and like I got the check, and I'm like, "Dang, Greg's gonna be mad at me."
You know what? He should have stolen crab legs. Those
are
really
expensive.
Those are messed up.
That's a good point.
You know, I have cravings, and all of a sudden I'll look and I'll go, "How much is that one leg?" And they'll say it's $38.50, and you're like,
"Absolutely not."
Wow. Does it walk? I mean,
it did at one point. And the problem is I'd probably overcook it, so it's like not even worth it.
Yeah.
Well, good. That was funny.
Yeah.
Was that it? Was that the only one? I thought that was fun. I'm like, wait, do we have another headline?
No, there's going to be another game.
Another game.
But it's going to be later on. Okay, so here's something that's I found interesting. Dave Chappelle. You guys know Dave Chappelle?
Chappelle Show.
I like him.
Yeah, he's okay. Funny.
So I printed out something, if I can find it here.
Nervous where you're going with this.
No.
Going Dave Chappelle.
Okay, Dave Chappelle is obviously a very funny comedian, right? Mm-hmm. We know. He's very funny. He's edgy, pushes the envelope, not politically correct. He's offensive. He's an equal opportunity offender, right?
I think that's fair to say.
At the end of the day, he's pretty darn funny. Well, we found out this week that one of the things that he really doesn't like, you know what it is?
Cilantro.
Poor people.
Oh.
Cilantro.
Sorry. I hate cilantro.
That's
everyone
so
in my
funny.
Office is laughing.
automatically said.
Everyone in my office is laughing. That's like the one thing that I hate in life is cilantro.
You took me by surprise.
That took me by surprise.
I didn't think you were even going to answer that.
I hope my friends are listening because they're like, no, seriously, she really hates that. That is out of left field. Woo, poor
okay,
people.
So why do I say poor people? Well, Dave Chappelle is.
And how do you define poor people? Let's get serious.
No, yeah, I don't know how you do that. Okay, so I'm not going to do that deep of a dive on this thing, but I think it's kind of interesting. So Dave Chappelle is from a small town called Yellow Springs. It's in Ohio.
Okay,
Yellow Springs, population 3,872 in 2019. However many there is now, I don't know.
That's not a lot. Okay.
So Dave wants to build up the town he grew up in, and he's committed $65 million
for
a restaurant, comedy club, and other things, right?
Okay. Nice.
Then he heard that the zoning commission wanted to develop affordable housing in the town.
Okay.
Uh-oh. So he showed up to the city council meeting, told Yellow Springs City Council that if they go ahead. Well, no, it's funny. He walked up, he took his hat off, and he hit the microphone, right? Mm-hmm. And he goes, "You people are clowns." He goes, "I got to tell you something. If for some reason you pass this and you bring affordable housing in this town, I will pull all $65 million and you won't see a dime of it."
Wow.
Well, is there a large need for affordable housing in a town that has less than 4,000
people? Small town, too, yeah.
Yeah.
Really.
So he said he'd pull all $65 million. He stood up there, took his hat off. Like I said, he smacked it. He said, "You guys." He goes, how dare you guys make me come up here and audition in front of this microphone?
Oh.
Which I thought was interesting. And then he
so
goes, "You people look like clowns." And so he said, "By the way, I'm serious. I'm dead serious." And he obviously won because they scrapped the whole low-income housing thing.
Wow.
Wow.
Interesting.
But if you think about it, I mean, it's bad. I mean, he goes, "I'm not against..." Well,
I don't think that means he doesn't like poor people, per se. I feel like that's a bad characterization.
Yeah.
If we're trying to build up the city, and then, yeah, I can see that those are competing.
And that's not a good thing. Yeah, he says he doesn't have a problem with low-income housing. He just has a problem with the people who live in it. That's what he said.
Interesting.
So that's why I'm deducing that he doesn't. Okay. What else? This is fun.
You tell me. You get to start off with all your foolishness, and then I rein you in.
Know.
So you got you have some time left for the foolishness.
With the foolishness,
we got time.
How about this? The head of Florida State University security. Head of Florida State University security.
Sorry, I thought I heard a dog barking in the background.
Is it? What's going on?
No,
it's just Andrew.
Oh.
Andrew,
no.
Shh. I'm kidding.
It's not him.
Is Andrew barking?
It sounds like a barking dog.
No, someone's laughing out there.
Okay.
Whoever you are out there, sorry.
Head of Florida State University security.
Of course it's in Florida. I mean, when I read this, I'm like, I wonder what state.
Decided to steal 5,000 rare comic books from the school, from Florida State University. Why they had 5,000 rare comic books there, I don't know. And then, of course, now he's not brilliant. Right, he took them, and then, of course, he tried to sell them on social media and also tried to sell them at a local comic book store. The comic book store owner called the police, and he was arrested.
I've always wondered about this. Like, when people do, like, high-profile robberies, it's like, okay, you've got Kim Kardashian's, like, $15 million ring. Like, what are you going to do with it?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure there's some, like, black market or whatnot, but I don't know.
Didn't
like you steal the TV and then you walk down to the pawn shop and like stolen TV.
It makes sense that they would be small so you could carry them. It's not like
the stealing isn't a hard part, but like ding ding, don't go down to the comic shop.
Well,
right?
It reminds me of a miniseries that I'm watching right now called Pam and Tommy or Tommy and Pam.
I haven't watched it, but I saw it.
Well, he actually goes and steals a safe out of Tommy Lee's garage. This safe is as tall as he is, and he took one little dolly and put the safe that probably weighs 1,000 pounds, puts it on the dolly, runs it out to his truck, and supposedly puts it in his truck. So it's easier to steal 5,000 comic books than it is 1,000 pounds safe by himself.
No, yeah, that's not
which
happening.
Is crazy. Okay, so how about this one? Timing is everything.
Oh, as always, yes.
While mortgage companies' profits were going through the roof when it comes to lending money, it was never a better time for the last 2 years for some of these mortgage companies to go public, right?
Right, if, which we've talked about in and out and up and down.
You own a company, you want to go public, man. Mm-hmm. You are set for life. It started with Rocket Mortgage.
You hope.
Yeah, exactly. Rocket mm-hmm. Mortgage and their parent company, Rocket Companies, and continued with United Wholesale Capital, Loan Depot, Guild Mortgage, Home Point Capital, and Finance of America, all of which we probably heard of at mm-hmm. one point or another.
Yep.
Six mortgage companies in all. They pulled the trigger and went public. Their debut raised a combined market capitalization of $69 billion.
I told my husband the other day, I was like, I don't even think I can count to a billion. I'm like...
It would take you a while.
Yeah, I probably could. Yes, good point. $69 billion, that's crazy.
However, it was good timing for investors to take advantage of trying to make money with these public offerings. But within less than 2 years, that $69 billion in market capital is down to $36 billion. If you are keeping score at home, that's over $1.5 billion a month that they lost. The owners of these mortgage companies are fat and happy, and the investors are crying in their beer.
When you have that much money, like, do you really, like, at what point do you notice a dent, right? Like, I have my Bank of America account, so when they get below a certain amount, I get like a bring, what the heck you doing? Stop spending money, right? Or like, I have a budget thing set up, and it's like, stop going to Nordstrom, like, you've meet your quota. Like, I wonder people like this, you know, at what point, like, oh, honey, we lost $1 billion. I don't know.
Well, didn't what's his face Zuckerberg lose like $17 billion in a day or something?
Yeah, I'm like, woo. Wow. No, thank you.
Yeah, but I got a hunch. Well, business wise, obviously, it's a drag. But I mean, still, they're pulling down the same amount of money.
Right.
You know that they're pulling down.
They may have to like gotten rid of one helicopter. Right.
Could be.
Could be.
Could be.
Interesting.
Let's see. What is this one? Tap that equity. Tap that equity. Right?
Okay, yes.
Thanks to record home price increases, the average U.S. mortgage holder now has $185,000 in tappable equity.
Which is what we talked about last week, remember, because I'd like to refresh everyone's memory. Phil decided to get on the Nextdoor app and participate and contribute because everyone was saying things are going to be foreclosed, and Phil couldn't help himself and said, no, because there's equity, and if you have equity, you won't foreclose. And I told you, have you responded since last Friday?
No.
Good.
Yeah. No, it's, when I put down there, okay, this is the last time I'm going to try to explain it to you people, right? But that was only one person that was really just to like a fly in my ointment.
Got it.
Right? And he was just like, it was almost like he was, yeah.
Yeah, a contrarian. And I go, anyway.
So then I had to make sure that he understood, and I think he did. Okay, so they've got $185,000 tap at a buck, but it's no longer a given that this $10 trillion market.
The average U.S., by the way, that's not California, that's U.S.
Yes,
I think that's great.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
But it's no longer given that this $10 trillion market will be owned by traditional lenders providing mm-hmm. cash out refis and HELOCs. HELOCs. And HELOCs. There's a growing army of alternative equity providers, including EasyKnoc, mm-hmm. Fraction, HomeTap, Knoc, Noah, Patch Homes, Point, and Unison. With Unison recently closing a securitization of $443 million in residential equity agreements, institutional investors are warming to the idea of taking an equity stake in future single-family homes in exchange for a share of future profits.
I mean, that's just life. That's the market, right? It's going to change.
That's
it's going to be different. Investing is going to look different.
I still don't understand how that works. So in other words, you've got a bunch of equity, and I say, okay, you want to borrow it? Oh, that's fine. I'll lend you the money, but mm-hmm. I get a percentage of the income as you sell,
right.
If you sell. Mm-hmm. What if you don't sell? Can I make you
I'm
sell?
I'm sure it's a little bit more complicated than
it's
that.
Like, there's so many things like, well, wait, what if this happens?
A contract that I would look at.
Guess what we have to do?
Take a break.
Sell some cars.
Cars.
Or something.
Ooh, I like it. All right, well, stay tuned. We
stay
have
tuned.
More fun
just
stuff.
Just going to get more interesting. More games.
Just can't get enough, guy. Just always so puff, guy. I'm that bad type. Make your mama sad type. Make your girlfriend mad.
If you're thinking of selling your home, have Phil Nordella come out and give you a free, no obligation, property valuation. Just call 661-312-3561. It's that simple.
Donahoe Young & Williams is your award-winning go-to law firm for all real estate matters, including the changing legal landscape due to COVID-19. In addition, Donahoe Young & Williams can help you create an estate plan that accomplishes your wishes, protects you and your family, and avoids time-consuming and expensive California probate. If you've been financially devastated by the pandemic, Donahoe Young & Williams can help with debt negotiation and, when needed, bankruptcy. Under Chapter 7, 11, and 13. Visit Taylor Williams at dywlaw.com.
Are you confused with all the craziness that's going on with the real estate market these days? Well, if you are, you're not alone. I'm Phil Nordella, and I have the knowledge and experience to help guide you through all the confusion. I'll answer your questions and help advise you so that you can accomplish your real estate goals. You can call me directly at 661-312-3561 or get online at philnordella.com. And don't forget, you can always listen to my radio show called Real Estate It's That Simple here on KHTS every Friday morning at 10 a.m. Phil Nordella, eXp Realty, it's that simple.
Castle Inspection is the top choice for home inspection in Santa Clarita. With over 20 years' experience, make Castle Inspection your choice when buying your new condominium or home. From mobile homes to mansions, the outhouse to the penthouse, your best bet is a net from Castle Inspection. An inspection is a fair and objective evaluation of the home's physical and mechanical systems. Expert knowledge, thorough research, and clear communication are what sets a net at Castle above the rest. Schedule your appointment online now at castleinspection.com. Take the stress out of moving. Affordable Quality Moving and Storage has been owned and operated in Santa Clarita since 1996. They excel at relieving you of the pressures of moving. You can be assured your belongings are safe and will arrive at your new location, whether it's down the street or across the country. Discover the difference. AQMS, Affordable Quality Moving and Storage. Read the reviews online at aqmsnationalmoving.com. AQMS, Santa Clarita's favorite moving company.
Your hometown station.
KHTS is the only station I listen to.
98.1 FM and AM 1220.
Hey, okay, welcome back to Real Estate and Other Stuff on KHTS 1220 AM and 98.1 FM and on Facebook Live.
Hello.
Yes. By the way, you're right. I didn't say hi to Greg. Hi, Greg. Are you watching?
He's not. He's flying
somewhere. Triple G.
Whatever.
He was texting me earlier in the air, although I probably shouldn't tell you that.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I didn't hear that.
I'm a bad wife. I don't. He's flying. I don't know where he's flying. Somewhere. Sorry, babe.
He's flying somewhere.
I looked this morning. I've been up since like 4 a.m. It's like that. That's like the last thing that I keep track of.
I got a question for you, though.
Oh, okay.
When you first started dating, you always knew where he was going, huh? You always know. Oh, where are you? You know what? My boyfriend, he's probably above Albuquerque.
So
right
first
now.
Of all, I never sound like that. If you've met me. Second of all, no, I was actually irritated because people were like, where is he? I was like, I don't know. Like, where is he? I don't know. And then people were like, you're a really bad girlfriend. So we have, hopefully I can say this word. We have a on the fridge of our apartment, it is a whiteboard and it says, where the hell is Greg? And every month, right, he wipes it off and then we put in the dates and then he flies, he puts the airport codes and then what time he lands at
funny.
Home. So I know. And then he screenshots it, sends it to me and my assistant, she prints it out. We put it on my desk at the office so I know all the time where he is. So, so now when you ask, I can look at my phone and be like, he's in Albuquerque or he's...
Albuquerque.
Wow. Yeah.
Albuquerque. Turn left at Albuquerque.
I mean, Albuquerque. So I have it easily accessible.
That's
so,
good.
Yeah.
That's good. Because I just thought maybe when you're dating, maybe it's really cute.
No,
right
I
now,
did.
Well, let's see what time is it. It's 10, 12. He should be right now. He should be right above Phoenix.
Oh, that involves time zones. No, but I did do some research as to airport codes.
Oh.
Because I didn't, like, a lot of the airport codes, I was like, yeah. My dad's like, yeah, you may want to, like, invest in using your brain and learning that.
Kind of like
fair,
dumb, LAX.
Fair. Okay.
That's one, isn't it?
Yes. We digress. Anyway, hi, babe. Sorry about that. Okay, so we've got some fun stuff.
Yes, we do.
And a game, apparently. And
yes,
I'm
we got
like,
another game.
I'm on a winning streak.
Yeah, and you know what? I'm starting to like these games. You know?
Yeah,
they're kind of fun.
Okay, I'm going to have to come up with a game next week or the week after so you guys can play.
I will do horribly.
You will not.
No,
you're still going to beat me.
I'm going to tailor it toward Patty.
Great.
So.
Star Wars or
oh, I, no,
Comic
I'd
Cons
win,
or
I'd
something.
Win that.
Yeah, 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 I got no shot.
No.
Okay. Let's see. Here's a soap opera. Okay, a soap opera.
It's a novella. It's a shady soap opera.
Yes. Yeah. We'll call it As the Stomach Turns. Boom, 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 boom. Keller Williams CEO Mark Willis, okay, poised to jump to eXp Realty amid legal dispute.
Okay.
So I'm going to read this, and I'm going to kind of explain it. The recruitment revelation was revealed in an 11-page motion filed on Monday by eXp World Holdings in a bid to dissolve Keller Williams' temporary restraining order against Willis. So what the heck does that mean?
That means that they are stopping him from jumping ship, going over to eXp for reasons that you will go through.
And why would they do that? It's really pretty simple. So Keller Williams had a guy named Mark Willis, and he worked for them for a long time, mm-hmm. and he grew their company. I mean, mm-hmm. he was instrumental in growing their company. And it says here, Keller Williams sent Willis an eXp letter threatening legal action in January. He wanted to leave them. Let me go back here. Willis helped grow the Texas-based behemoth from a regional firm in 1991 to a worldwide force with more than 140,000 agents at the time of his departure in 2014. He left them in 2014, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. So now he wants to go to eXp. He hasn't worked for them for 8 years? And he wants to go to eXp.
Good math.
Yeah.
That was quick.
Keller Williams sent Willis an eXp letter threatening legal action in January after learning Willis's plan to join the rival firm. Keller Williams said Willis's ownership stake in a franchise in two regions gave him access to more than 150 confidential data reports that he would inevitably share with eXp to cause irreparable damage to Keller Williams' intellectual property, confidential information, goodwill, and system.
Written by a lawyer.
You think?
Yeah.
It's even hard to say.
you should have had me read it.
In their motion, eXp said Keller Williams' concerns about Willis access to confidential data would be alleviated if they allowed Willis to sell his remaining... He's got these offices.
So eXp is saying, all right, fine. Let him get rid of all of this stuff, and then he'll jump on over.
Of which he's been trying to do for 8 years.
That's what you were saying.
Yeah. He says, however, they claim Keller Williams has prevented Willis from selling his interest, as they have the right to first refusal.
Yeah.
And what they're doing is they're saying, hey, on information and belief, in the weeks following January 6th, Defendant Willis attempted to engage with Keller Williams to facilitate the divestiture of his Keller Williams investments. He's saying, look, I'm trying to sell them. Keller Williams refused to negotiate in good faith and interfered with prospective purchases mm-hmm. of Willis's interest, thus further impeding eXp's
impeding.
Right to hire him. So
impeding.
What did I say?
Impending.
Oh, well, I get on. I'm on a move.
He's excited.
You know, you can't hit a moving
just
target.
Just trying to help, you know.
impeding.
Yeah, so that's crazy.
Yeah. And so it says a source familiar with the matter backed up eXp's claim and told Inman, Keller Williams' founder, Gary Keller, he went ballistic when Willis, who spent 25 years helping Keller Williams rise to the top of the industry, he said he wanted to sell his interest and join eXp. He lost it.
I would be interested to see what his employment contract, if he had one. I mean, obviously, if he's the CEO, then they have something in writing, what it says in terms of, you know, participation in the future, competition, who with whom he can work, that type of stuff.
Well, you know what's funny is it doesn't really bring that up.
Correct. I know, which I think is
the allegation is that is inevitable that eXp will join confidential KW information
right.
if it hires Willis is legal and factually baseless, and eXp seeks to intervene to defend against those allegations.
Especially if he's saying, okay, you know, here's all the stuff. Let me sell said stuff and move on with my life. So.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And here's the follow-up to that, which I think is interesting.
This makes it the soap opera.
It says right here, eXp president of operations okay. heads to Keller Williams as rivalry builds.
What?
Yep, eXp president of operations Stacy Onan is going to Keller Williams, and it was announced Friday, 2 days after eXp World Holdings' Glenn Sanford raises issues over recruitment in a tweet.
Couldn't they just do, like, you know, when they exchange hostages between countries, like, fine, give
exactly
us this
right.
one, we'll give you that one,
yeah.
right?
Yeah,
and
yeah,
then
yeah,
they
yeah,
walk
yeah.
across a bridge or something.
But I'm wondering just exactly how much more they paid to Stacy just for the fact that they wanted her to take somebody away from them. It's like, okay, well, you know what?
Ooh, you think it's that type of play?
Oh, yeah, oh no. Oh. Yeah, with the type of money that they have, you know, they're probably saying, look, normally we'd pay you $500,000 a year, but... if you sign today and today only,
and today
we'll
only.
Give you a $200,000 signing bonus, and right. we'll give you yeah free Yankee tickets or whatever.
I mean, you know, open market, free competition, whatnot. I mean, I get Keller Williams being concerned about he's going over to EXP and he has confidential information. But if he's doing stuff that he can to, you know, call it kind of partitioning yourself, if you will, in the legal world to not share that information, they need to
It's funny that they're, the program, that they're so Keller upset Williams. With this guy when they took president of operations. Know, Gee, do you think that she knows some
that
things?
That one who's probably way more involved than said dude that's been like yeah, on a boat for the last 8 years
exactly
drinking
right.
champagne,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it's like, wow.
He's probably the one that's like, oh, we lost a billion. I should probably get a job for the next year or so, right? Shady.
Fine.
That's what we need a stinger for.
Just
some sort of like, you know,
oh, we do.
Shady.
We'll get one. We'll get one.
Real estate.
Just,
yeah.
Just
it's that
like,
shady. Yeah, exactly. Maybe Patty could do it.
You could. Yeah. You could.
Do the voiceover for it?
Yes, for the shady
Definitely.
Thing.
It's shady.
Slim Shady.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's our game.
I like it.
You ready?
Oh, yes. Okay.
Okay, I'm going to give you, you guys can just throw these out one at a time,
oh, no.
right?
Okay.
And then you count them up yourself, because obviously I'm not going to keep score for you guys.
I'll
You're going to have to do it. Right?
Have pen, can tally.
And so this is,
I'm nervous.
In 2021, okay. the most popular How to Become search. Okay, so you're sitting there and saying,
oh.
you know what? I wonder how do I do this? Or what kind of job am I going to actually look into?
So is it job related? Because that
Yes,
okay,
it is job,
job
related.
Okay.
okay.
So not
so
like how to become a millionaire.
There's actually, I want to say that there's 10, but there's not. There really is 9 because one's not really a job. I mean, it can be, but it's usually something that's added after you actually have a job and you want to actually maybe just do this also.
Okay.
So.
How do you go first?
These are by state Google searches of how to become something, and I'm going to cover it all up, and then you guess. You get to go first.
Yeah, you go first.
I'm gonna say now. When I say this one, I'm gonna say an influencer, like a YouTuber or
a
podcaster.
Yeah,
something
Hang
of that.
Second. Hang on a
something
second.
Something of like that
Hang on
related.
A second.
That's a good one.
Okay, you get it. You get
Ah.
I feel like I want to say what I want to say, but no one would Google this because it's a thankless profession. How to become a real estate agent.
Okay, yes. Okay,
I was going to say lawyer.
Yeah.
So
well, you figure. And she's really smart because obviously it was pulled from something real estate related.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Huh.
Okay.
That's my ace on the whole.
So, okay. So that means because she's really smart and that she knew that, you get two picks. Okay.
Oh,
and then you're going to go back and forth.
Oh,
so
man.
So she gets a, you get a penalty pick. Okay.
I get a penalty. Oh, like an
sympathy
like,
pick. pick.
Sympathy pick.
Oh, okay.
Oh my God.
Sympathy pick. That's terrible.
All right,
you started it.
I'm gonna say marketer.
Marketer, what is that?
Somebody
like
to go shopping for eggs
Someone
and bacon
who does,
and
like,
stuff.
Like,
you mean
grocer?
No, like market, like a marketing person.
I know, silly.
Like PR is, marketing.
Hang
yeah,
on a
all that. It's
that's not there, Patty.
Okay,
so, social
one more.
I get
one
a
more.
Penalty.
One more.
Penalty kick.
Yes, yes, yes.
More.
Penalty kick. Come on, come on, come on.
Firefighter.
Oh.
Ding, ding, ding,
Yay!
Ding, ding,
that's
ding,
a good, one.
Good for you.
Woo!
Good for you. Okay, it's 1-1.
Oh,
go ahead.
No. That's actually what I was going to say.
Oh.
Darn it.
You're lucky. Good one, 2-0.
I took it from her.
Yep.
Well, I can just say Woo! Mine that I know is wrong to speed up time. How to become a lawyer. I know that's not on there.
Yeah, no.
Yeah. I know that's not on there.
How do you become a lawyer? Although there is one kind of stupid in here to where you just figured the answer would be go to school. Go ahead.
Got it.
Teacher.
Sorry, they're on two pages.
Just pull them next to each other. I'm not gonna look.
Yes, you are.
I'm not.
She's looking.
Look at that.
I did not look.
Yes.
I swear I was not looking.
Teacher. No.
Oh.
Doctor.
Okay, doctor. No.
Oh.
Okay, we'll start rifling through these. Go ahead.
Policeman.
Policeman.
Oh, that was gonna be my next one.
Policeman.
I'm just going to generalizations.
Policeman.
Here.
No.
We covered firefighter and all that stuff.
I don't know. Event planner.
Oh, yeah.
Event planner, no.
I am going to say investigator, like a detective. PI.
No.
Okay.
A banker, something in finance.
Oh, yeah, that too.
No. You each get two more.
A broker.
Okay. I think that's
a
the same
broker?
Thing.
Broker? No, that's real. Yeah, okay. That'd be a real estate agent. Pretty close.
Would anybody put in there how to become famous?
No.
How to be a millionaire.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Famous, millionaire. No.
Okay. No.
All right, your last
a singer.
One. Oh, that's a good one.
Singer, no. How to become a singer.
How to become an engineer.
Nope.
Okay, with that, we stink.
We're tied.
We are tied.
Number two.
Okay.
number one was real estate agent.
Woo woo.
Number two was flight attendant.
Oh, sorry, Greg.
Oh, Greg's looking at you.
Pilot
like,
didn't even cross my mind.
Well,
I'm the worst wife.
In all fairness,
sorry,
pilot wasn't on there.
Okay, that's fair. True. No, and I that's wouldn't true. Have thought of flight attendant.
That's true.
Yeah. No, I'm sorry. Okay.
Next.
How do you become a pilot? Yeah. Next one. This is not really a job. It's something that you do. It's notary.
Notary.
So that's
got
that's
it.
Not.
What about dog walker?
Number four. Number four. Therapist. How to become a therapist?
I didn't think about that.
Oh shoot.
What?
Number five, pilot.
Ah!
Greg.
Patty, you win for shame, Patty.
Oh
you win.
She loses a point because of the pilot.
Number six, you guys got. You got firefighter.
Yay!
Number seven, personal trainer.
No.
How do you become a personal trainer? Number eight,
I guess so.
How do you become a psychiatrist?
No.
That
These
works.
These are weird. Okay.
Isn't number that the same nine. Thing as a therapist, though? It, or similar?
It, yeah, it is.
No,
number
it's
nine.
Not. One can prescribe medication.
Yeah. Number nine, physical therapist.
Okay.
Which
a lot
is
of them
probably
the therapy
yeah.
Here.
And number 10, electrician.
Electrician.
Electrician, just to throw it in there.
Yeah.
My brother
yeah.
was an electrician for a minute. Golly, I failed miserably at this one.
Well,
right,
same.
Sorry.
But
I don't
blame know.
Cameron
was
lack
it,
of sleep.
Was it a tie?
It was a tie, but I'm giving it to Patty because my husband's profession was on there and it didn't cross my mind, and I'm a bad wife.
Honestly,
so,
yes.
I sympathy win.
Yeah,
you got a sympathy pick
and a sympathy win.
You got a sympathy win.
Hey man, a win is a win. You take that.
Yeah,
I will take this.
That.
I will put
it's
a
like,
plaque on this on my room.
It's like if you hit a bad shot in golf and it rolls across the ground and then goes in the hole. It doesn't. You can't tell how it got there on the scorecard, right?
That's true.
It's just a hole in one, right?
So we used to say in law school when things are really difficult, D's get degrees. I never got a D. I would just like to say for the record, but
glad
I don't
you're not
think.
A, glad you're not a yeah. doctor.
All right.
Okay, so do we have any more time right now before we break?
We got a little.
Okay.
You want to talk about the metaverse?
Oh, metaverse.
I think it's interesting.
And it's very interesting, mm-hmm. but metaverse.
I saw a segment on Good Morning America the other day about the metaverse, and so I did some time researching, and you pulled an article about the metaverse, so I
hey,
feel like...
you know what? You can't afford to buy a house? Well, then why don't you buy one in the metaverse?
Whoa.
Is it called the metaverse or just metaverse?
Metaverse. I think it's like the... Okay. I don't know. We're California, the 405, the 101, the metaverse, right? It's the same thing.
This is from Inman. It says, the article says, metaverse investors to real estate agents, butt out.
Right. You're useful in real life, but get the heck out of the metaverse.
Yeah.
You want to buy an island over there, Phil? We don't need you to help Taylor buy her island
in
the metaverse.
If I want
to
buy a cartoon, I don't need a realtor, basically. Okay.
So, yeah, but that's
Janine Yorio, CEO of Republic Realm. Said that the role of a third-party broker in digital worlds may look unlike its counterpart in reality.
Okay.
Duh.
Yeah.
In the crypto world, the middleman is the villain, she says.
Or woman. Just making you laugh today. It's one of those things.
As the idea of buying and selling virtual land in immersive metaverse platforms gains attention, a few luxury brokers may have a high-profile splash in this space.
I'm so interested. Like, wait a minute. We have competition to buy a real house, but now I have to put my hat in the ring for a metaverse house?
Unbelievable. Yorio's company, Republic Realm, buys virtual tracts of land.
That's crazy.
In multiple metaverses,
yeah.
builds out that land with structures and activities and keeps close tabs on the state of the startup industry. In November, the company announced, and I don't want to say what I was going to say, and I blank you not.
You do, but
okay?
You can't say what you want
In
to
November,
say.
The company announced it had completed the largest virtual land transaction in any metaverse, scooping up 3 square miles of the sandbox, which is what they call the one that's really cool. They got it for nearly $4.3 million worth of cryptocurrency.
It's wild to me. I just like
what?
Me, like my lawyer logical brain goes to like, okay, what are the parameters? Like, what is the acreage that we're starting with, right? Like, because arguably, you know, you could be like, listen, I bought Black Acre over here and it's mine. But then so-and-so's like, no, there is no Black Acre in the metaverse. Like, what? My brain can't handle
you
it.
You know what? I'm glad that they're saying, you know, realtors butt out.
Yeah.
Right? Because a realtor, if they really are worth anything, they would go, You're thinking of buying this for $4.3 million?
Let me see what I can show you here in beautiful Santa Clarita. Yeah.
That you can actually live in.
Yeah. And you know what? And we'll put in a sandbox in the back for you for
if
free.
If you want a sandbox, you got a sandbox.
This is a great idea.
In fact, you know what? Your sandbox can be the beach because you can actually live on the ocean for $4.3 million.
Wild.
Unbelievable. So
this is like Cameron, when he gets older, is going to be like, Mom. Duh, the metaverse, like blah, blah, blah. I own a condo and blah, blah, blah. And Greg and I are going to be like crying in the corner.
And the sad part is,
drinking our wine. Yeah, like,
he's going to say, by the way, I bought that, you know, a couple of weeks ago and I just sold it for $17 million more. And you're like, oh.
Where's the money? Move out. Yeah, exactly.
Move out. So interesting. I just thought that was funny.
It is, yeah. I don't get how it works. I'm just, you know. We're old, I guess. That's
the fact that they thought that a realtor would try to get involved in buying a cartoon. Thought really interesting. Yeah.
Anyway,
but
quick break.
Back to it. Yes, yeah, we gotta go sell some more stuff.
Okay, we'll be right back.
Okay.
Like you really rough guy, just can't get enough guy, just always so puff guy.
If you're thinking of selling your home, have Phil Nordella come out and give you a free, no obligation property valuation. Just call 661-312-3561. It's that simple.
Castle Inspection is the top choice for home inspection in Santa Clarita. With over 20 years' experience, make Castle Inspection your choice when buying your new condominium or home. From mobile homes to mansions, the outhouse to the penthouse, your best bet is a net from Castle Inspection. An inspection is a fair and objective evaluation of the home's physical and mechanical systems. Expert knowledge, thorough research, and clear communication are what sets a net at Castle above the rest. Schedule your appointment online now at castleinspection.com.
Are you confused with all the craziness that's going on with the real estate market these days? Well, if you are, you're not alone. I'm Phil Nordella, and I have the knowledge and experience to help guide you through all the confusion. I'll answer your questions and help advise you so that you can accomplish your real estate goals. You can call me directly at 661-312-3561 or get online at philnordella.com. And don't forget, you can always listen to my radio show called Real Estate It's That Simple here on KHTS every Friday morning at 10 a.m. Phil Nordella, EXP Realty, it's that simple.
Donahoe Young & Williams is your award-winning go-to law firm for all real estate matters, including the changing legal landscape due to COVID-19. In addition, Donahoe Young & Williams can help you create an estate plan that accomplishes your wishes, protects you and your family, and avoids time-consuming and expensive California probate. If you've been financially devastated by the pandemic, Donahoe Young & Williams can help with debt negotiation and, when needed, bankruptcy under Chapter 7, 11, and 13. Visit Taylor Williams at dywlaw.com.
I love it.
Right on!
Your hometown station.
Okay, hey, welcome back to Real Estate and Other Stuff, a lot of other stuff, on KHTS 1220 AM and 98.1 FM and on Facebook Live. I'm still your friend in the real estate business, Phil Nordella, and we're here with, obviously, Taylor Williams-Moniz, who is your friend in the attorney business.
And there is such a thing.
She's a full partner, obviously, at Donahoe Young & Williams, and she's also premier attorney firm in the Santa Clarita Valley.
Thank you.
Yes.
I think we are. We do good work.
Mm-hmm. And she is amazing.
Well, thank you very much. Amazing. Except for when you say, I want to do this. And I go, nope, which is what just happened off the air.
Yeah. Yikes. Hey, Greg, you know, there was a chill in here. And so I'm just wondering if that ever happens. You have to wear your coat inside anytime.
Okay.
Hey, listen, according to Inman, 75% of home buyers acknowledge some regret over recent home buy. Really? Now, this is a little bit misleading.
Yes,
okay?
Agreed.
Because it does sound like, oh, God, 75%, they all feel that they made a mistake, which is not true.
Well, some regret. So what is the level and what specifically do they feel regret about? That's my
question, right. And you know, the funny thing is most people, when they actually put their comments, ton of comments, you know what the actual question was? The question was, why did they put a picture of a woman in her bra?
Oh.
Or why can you see her bra strap? That's what most people actually responded.
Oh, in the comments on Inman. Got it. I'm like, what are you talking about? After they purchase a home?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's not the stock photo I would use.
It's very strange.
It's a woman that kind of, like, she looks like my age in a romper, but her bra is hanging out, and her head is against
up against the wall. Like she's banging her head against the wall like they made a mistake, which, like I said, is misleading. Three-quarters of the survey participants who purchased a home in the last 2 years had some regrets of at least one aspect of their new home, according to an analyst released Tuesday by Zillow. Now, everybody has you're not going to get 10 out of 10 things. It's
correct.
Impossible.
We've talked about that.
If you
many
can get 8 out of 10, that's great. So
that's
there's
great.
Always going to be something. Mm-hmm. So
6 out of 10 D's get degrees.
Exactly right. Three-quarters of recent home buyers expressed regrets about their new homes.
Like what?
Okay. So Zillow found the most common regrets home buyers had was buying a home that was too small.
This is the biggest
problem.
Right, Greg and I, that's our huge thing, is like it has to be over a certain amount of square footage,
yep.
right? Because that's
yep.
we
I can't
we
tell
need
you, you know, people will send me stuff and say, hey, Phil, can you show me this? And I'll go, yeah, but it's 500 square feet smaller than you were thinking.
No.
You know, you said minimum 2,000. It's 1,500 square feet. I don't think that's going
to
work.
You were about to say it was 500 square feet in total. I'm like, girl, my closet. No.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's 31%. They also found that 32% of buyers regretted buying a house that required more maintenance than they were bargained for.
So what do you think they mean maintenance? Like there's a pool, landscaping, that type of thing?
I guess. You know, I guess they just didn't think that stuff, you know, maybe they thought it would handle itself. But, I mean, no matter what, you got to figure if you got a pool, you're probably looking at $100 a month. And depending on the size of your property,
right.
if you've got a landscaper, you know, some kind of gardener, it's going to cost you.
Heck yeah.
Right? Okay, nearly three-quarters respondents said that they wished they had done at least one thing differently, while 40% they wished they had taken more time to weigh their options, which makes sense. Sometimes you get an actual thing, no matter what you think. It's called the bigger, better deal. Mm-hmm. Also, when you actually get into escrow, you can always tell the conversation changes a little bit because the people are like, so what do you think, Phil? And they're always asking me to reiterate.
Like,
exactly
it's,
right.
I mean, for the majority of people, this is the largest purchase you're ever going to make.
Yep.
So
and they're always
deal.
Afraid if for some reason that something else is going to come up as soon
right.
as theirs closes.
Right.
Okay, so one of the guys said here, and I agree with this, buyers can get distracted by pretty kitchen or great staging when they should concentrate instead on the two biggest factors, its layout and its location.
Yeah.
You can't change, you know, those are stuff that it's hard to change unless you own a mobile home. Then you can change the location.
Right.
Other
or
than
you're
that.
Gonna gut the thing, but no, let's
yep.
not do that. So that makes sense.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I thought so.
Yeah.
Okay, so you wanted to do the Bay Area thing.
No, you can do whatever you want. I'll allow it.
You're the best.
Of course.
You're the best.
You hear that, Greg?
I thought that this was interesting. What hers was Open Door actually opened up in the Bay Area, which is nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
So there's that.
This one
there.
Is the housing market too hot, so why isn't prop tech? Mm-hmm. I've never even heard of the word prop tech.
Neither had I. So
I didn't know
Google.
That had something mm-hmm. to do with the fact that I guess it has something to do with stock prices. Because it says here, stock prices for a new wave of publicly traded real estate companies have declined dramatically, starting with Zillow's stumble. What went wrong? What does it mean for innovation? And I'll just tell you what happened here, because I know we're running out of time. One of the hottest housing markets in history and the strong stock markets in a decade, one basket of stocks has been a disaster. And those are including Zillow, Redfin, Compass, mm-hmm. eXp, Opendoor, and OfferBet. They've gone from 65 to 75% down.
Right.
I remember eXp, when I first joined them, they were $9, and they went to 180 and split. Then they were at 90. Now they're at like 30. And it's like,
so
ouch.
I don't look at
yeah.
my stocks.
No, that hurts.
Nope.
The Seattle-based company of Zillow lost $35 billion in market value in the last 12 months. And so are these,
that's
the
question
is.
So if the housing market is doing so well, what the heck is happening with
that's
Zillow,
what I don't
eXp,
understand.
Open Door? Well, you have a minute to explain it
so
to us. Because I'm inquiring why and want to know.
But I will tell you this. You know how they say in stocks you buy the dip?
Right.
Well, they're dipped. I mean, they're
so maybe
dipped.
They're done.
They're dipped out. No, the dip. No, I'm thinking that unless we go into a really problematic area, mm-hmm. that these are going to be stocks that are coming back. That's why. But I bought some Zillow last night.
I can't believe that you buried the lead. You should have led the show with that. You bought Zillow.
Well,
stock?
I just think, you know, they just got rid of $350 million with a debt.
That's crazy.
And so,
no,
anyway,
I think it's smart.
Hey, if somebody wants to get a hold of you, what would they do?
661-259-9000, or they can find us on our website at dywlaw.com. What about you?
You know, I even knew that. I knew the number. Yep.
Did you?
I did.
Yep.
I've got it memorized.
Yep.
You can call me at philnordella.com. Or call me at 661-312-3561.
Yep.
Happy birthday, Judy.
Happy birthday.
Happy Super Bowl.
Woo, and go Rams.
And everybody have a wonderful Valentine's Day.
Yes.
Go, Emily.
Woo.
Have a nice weekend, everybody.
Is horrified. That's our job as parents, to embarrass
That's our
you.
Job.
Thanks for listening.